Greetings and welcome back to Neurosciences Connections. I'm Bill Mobley, and I'm going to be talking today with a brand new member of our faculty, Dr. Santosh Kesari, a neuro-oncologist who's come to us from the East Coast and who's now establishing a first-class program in the care of people with brain tumors here at UCSD. You may know that brain tumors are a terrible problem. Almost 500,000 Americans suffer from brain tumors. It's the third leading cause of cancer-related deaths in middle age. And right now, though we have lots of ideas, we don't have really truly adequate therapies for these neoplasms of the brain. And so I'm here with Santosh to say welcome. Please tell us a little bit about yourself, your training, and your programs, both clinical and research here at UCSD.
Thank you, Bill, for inviting me. It's a wonderful opportunity for me to come here and to build a neuro-oncology program. As a neurologist and a scientist, this field requires great advances in order to help our patients. The treatments that we have right now for brain tumors, whether they are primary brain tumors that arise in the brain or metastatic cancers where they spread from breast or lung, are tremendous. And it's increasing in incidence over time because the oncologists, the general oncologists, are very good at controlling the disease locally. So as neuro-oncologists, we're seeing more and more of this in our clinics, and the patients are devastated, and there is no organized center in San Diego County to take care of these patients. And so what we're doing here at UCSD and Morse Cancer Center is really to bring all the resources on the clinical and research side to better understand brain tumors and to find more effective treatments. So what we're doing is really trying to understand the biology of the tumor better, understand why tumors go to the brain, what makes them grow, what makes them invade, what makes them metastasize, and that basic understanding will lead to better drugs so that we can study in our patients and get approved for use. The problem with brain tumors is, as you mentioned, they're very different. Each person's tumor is very different. Each glioma is very different. Each breast cancer patient where the tumors go to the brain are different subtypes. Each lung cancer patient, again, is also different. We've learned from the NIH Cancer Genome Atlas that each person's tumor has different genetic aberrations. And so what we're really looking at is trying to personalize treatments for our patients by doing the basic science of understanding what drives each person's tumor and then selecting the drugs for that patient. And our clinical trials are based on the laboratory work where we try to identify these genetic markers that predict response to different drugs. And then we do those clinical trials in our patients at UCSD and partnering institutions.
So it's quite special. It's quite unique. My tumor, my treatment may be very different from another person's tumor and treatment.
Absolutely. I think what we've learned over the last 5-10 years with all the trials that have been going on in other cancers and including especially brain tumors, we always find that it's about 10 to 20% of patients respond. And why is it always 10 to 20%? It's because we don't select the patients for the for the specific drugs we're using. We know how the drugs work. We know that there are specific mutations that make the tumors sensitive to the drugs, but yet we don't incorporate that information when we actually use it in our patients. And I think the era of personalized genomics, personalized medicine is here. We just have to utilize it in our patients. And at UCSD, that's exactly the type of program we're envisioning and want to establish and are already starting to do right now.
Great. Sounds hopeful.
Yes,
sounds
absolutely.
Like there's a real chance to make a difference.
Absolutely.
Terrific. Santosh, thanks for speaking.
Thank you.
Thanks for being with us, and come back soon to Neurosciences Connections.